Greetings and welcome to episode 130 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod USA campaign. And this, my friends, how we left it last time, where we are slowly but surely moving against all German forces here in the west, in the north of Europe here. We really are pushing out. Stuttgart is now ours. It's fallen to our forces last episode. But now we need to push back hard here. We need to move against Munich. But we still have a plethora of German forces in our way here. But we are systematically going to dismantle the German military machine here in the west. I can absolutely assure you, my friends. We've also evacuated the Don as well, which many of the council are pleased about. And I am also pleased about that. I'm glad I followed the council's advice. We've now pulled those forces out. We've moved them to Patras. They are diverging ideas of where we should send those troops, but the main one should be to Ankara. Many of the council saying we should move those forces to Ankara once they've been replenished and repaired, and move against the Ottomans and deal a death blow to the Ottomans once and for all. Bring the Middle East firmly under US control. Indeed, we are moving against the Mamluks as well at the same time. Also, there's been a call for us to reinforce the homeland, but also on the flip side of that, there's also been a call for us to not reinforce it too much. So to only have sort of the bare minimum of forces, all forces must be sort of diverted to Western Europe, as it were, to really put an end to this German facade, as it were, here at the moment. We can't allow them to regain their footing here. We're also moving the Marine Expeditionary Corps to and down further south here, just past Hungary. It's moving, where it's assembling for a strike against forces moving from the south to the north, German forces moving south to north. But I have a feeling we possibly might have some problems with the Spanish coming up very, very soon. We've taken Stuttgart, the final link between Spain and Germany. It really was the last trade link also for munitions and the movement of goods and indeed material and men as well. So we've got to be absolutely on the ball here. We cannot allow our gaze to slip away from Spain. I've just got that. Sometimes you get that gut feeling, and I think the council has got the same gut feeling there as well, that Spain is inevitably going to move against us. But let us focus on the task at hand here. That is to move against this force here, a force comprising of some very, very powerful German forces here. But for the longest time, we haven't been able to really pin down a German forces and overwhelm them, outnumber them in a battle. But now you start to see, as we reap the rewards of the battles we've taken place in the past, now we're starting to see our local superiority here take full effect. As you can see here, the Germans, although we must not dismiss these forces at all, albeit they do have militia, but these militia are experienced. They also have mortar, which is the absolute bane of our lives, but this force is not to be sniffed at all. They've got musketeers in here, they do have plenty of cannon as well. More musketeers as well. This is not a force here to be messed with at all, but as you can see, we outnumber them at least 2-1 here. A marvellous force here. Plenty of cuirassiers, plenty of heavy cavalry to do much damage. Lots of line infantry as well. Experienced line infantry. You can see these gentlemen have been in the mill, have been fighting in the mud and the blood here of the Western Front. 3 cannon, only 24 pounders. No howitzers, which could potentially pose a problem for us in terms of our sort of the depth of the damage we might be able to lay down upon the enemy, but we do have nearly 10,000 men in reserve here. And we are going to select our forces here, bring them in. This force here is and has been really, really in the absolute fight here, so we're going to leave this force to the very last. We want this force to replenish and repair. As you can see, it is down to 30 men, the cuirassiers, 16 men, the lancers. As you can see, that really was involved in some brutal fighting. I believe it's this force here. So we're going to leave that till last, but we do need a force that's going to bring some much needed firepower possibly to the battle if we need it. I think we will send this force in here. No council member in here as a general yet, but as you can see, we have a Republican Guard here, plenty of cuirassiers, which is exactly what we need. Only 1 cannon. So I think we'll have the cavalry moving in first. Always good to have that mobility. Then we shall have the Republican Guard, then we've got Fusiliers, and Garrison Guards. We'll have these gentlemen last, and then followed by Line Infantry. A wonderful setup there. And indeed, always having the cavalry first. That's just a personal choice, a personal preference. Oh, Lancers. They're an absolute brute on the charge. Cuirassiers, of course. And we've got some sharpshooters. I think we have the sharpshooters here. Let's move our line infantry into position. And again, the cannon and the artillery coming in last, but you will find that even though you put the artillery last, they usually come in first, which is a little bit baffling to say the least, but we shall take what we have in front of us. Again, more cuirassiers here, which we're going to move into position. We do also have more lancers. Let's put these gentlemen down here. As the last thing, we'll have the garrison guards, an elite force of garrison guards. We've got the sharpshooters who we'll leave. Actually, we'll put the sharpshooters at the front here. The 17th and 16th light foot. I think we are ready to proceed here. And they've also got a very small token force here. But again, oh, this force has taken a real battering there. So this force is at full strength, and so is this one. So we're not going to, you know, we're not going to walk away from this unscathed, shall we say. This is not, it's going to be a pretty brutal fight. We can just hope this army stays out of harm's way, because we need to replenish this one as quickly as possible. It is a battle-hardened experience, as you can see. The experience here of these forces is exemplary. But let us begin our fight here to free, at last, Saxony of German forces. And when they're going to move down, we're going to create a cauldron around Munich. And that cauldron is going to be impenetrable by German forces escaping or trying to break into it. Let's begin. Excuse me, my friends, we have a beverage here of tea, of course, to cleanse the palate before a battle. We shall not allow these German forces to escape. We just simply cannot, sir. And the council has also called for us to eliminate all forces, to destroy every single last regiment of enemy. We shall attempt to do that at this battle. We might be very aggressive, but since we have the forces behind us, I think we're going to be pretty aggressive here. We'll have a small defensive line. Unless the Germans barrel down upon us quite aggressively, we will ourselves be aggressive, pushing the flanks, using the cavalry we have. We've got a massive cavalry advantage. Some topography here is actually a fairly decent deployment here we have on this battlefield. As you can see, sloping quite aggressively here, downwards here, so it could put our artillery at a little bit of a disadvantage. Look at the artillery we've got here, look at that. I think we will actually put these gentlemen into a defensive line. Not behind the line, but actually in it, so we can use artillery, the canister shot when they get too far forward, and also shrapnel shot, which is absolutely brutal, sir. Now, we've got plenty of cavalry here for on the flanks, which is like exactly where we want them to be. Of course, one is going to be slightly top heavy than the other. Let's pull our line infantry back into the fold here. We've got this ruin, this church ruin here, which is slightly in our way here. So we can probably shift our axis of advance, or indeed our defense stroke attack, I think more to our left. We're going to move more down this way here. As you can see, the battlefield itself is relatively flat, and look how close the German forces are here. Very, very close indeed, sir. So again, if we can get on top of them quite quickly, we will shift our forces down here into this sort of small pocket here. Although this hill here could... Oh, look at that there. That's a huge dip. A huge sort of hill here, a canyon almost, some would say, a ravine, and here as well. So the undulation here of the ground here, the topography here, is quite startling. You've got this sort of, as I said, undulation of ground here, then this sort of flat area here with nothing apart from a small ridge here. But I think I prefer this flank here because of the flatness. It's going to allow the cavalry to move. We will be striking from two flanks, but the main shift of our weight here must be put on one side. Right, let's get ourselves organised here. We'll have some experienced regiments here defending. Let's make sure we're absolutely prepared here for what's coming, because, excuse me, my friends, remember, we will have additional German forces moving in immediately from the flanks, so we've got to be careful. German reinforcements come in immediately, ours do not. Ours come in on a staggered approach. So as you lose a regiment, you gain one. The Germans don't have that. They have the luxury of being able to pull forces straight into the battle. I think we'll have four regiments at least in defence. Let's get our cannons here. Let's have the this regiment here. Let's put ourselves in a really good spot here to defend Limba. We'll have them sit slightly back from the front lines because the Germans will tend to target them, but if they're slightly set back, it means they might have contact with these line infantry first. Set these gentlemen up here ready for defence. Excellent, look at that. We've got plenty of line infantry, but we might have to use cavalry as our main strike force. Just sort of hit and run, as it were. We don't want to get swamped here. Pull the general in already here, just so we've mark our line, mark our territory, as it were. Look at that. Now, 70th Regiment. We'll set up the 70th Regiment here on the right. Then we will see, because if you can see here, that hill there isn't too bad, but we'll set this regiment of artillery here and then set them back. Perfect. And I think we'll have another regiment here as well. So again, we adapt as we see fit here. We do have one more regiment here, which we can put in. I think we could probably put a script force, an attack force together here. We'll put three regiments to start with. 72nd, accompanied by two others. All these are battle-hardened forces here, so they're experienced troops anyway. So we know they're going to stand their ground in a fight, but we've got to choose a flank from which to hit the enemy from. We'll have one more regiment here, and then we'll have another line infantry. Excuse my friends, my voice seems to be croaking a bit here tonight. This is what we want, this regiment here. Let's set them fair. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. So we've got them in the lines here on a stagger line. I know the line is not very straight at all. That's a very, very rackety line there. That's more like it. Again, not straight. That's more like it, sir. And the wolves are out in force tonight, so we'll have another regiment here defending the extreme right. I think we'll pull this force in here, this regiment here on the extreme left. I think we'll also leave some cavalry behind to defend, because we don't know where those German reinforcements are going to come. Are they going to come in from behind, or are they going to come in from one of the flanks? They might even come from behind us. So again, we've got to be wary here. We've also managed to put together a strike force here of two regiments of cavalry and three regiments here, but I think we'll put another regiment of cavalry in here. Let us be slightly daring at least. We know we've got that mortar, which is going to be an absolute menace, but we will leave two regiments of cavalry behind the lines in reserve here. We are not going to be caught on the hop. Another cuirassiers here. Put them in a group so we have full control over our fire support. I would also just set our troops here fair. We've got plenty of distance here, plenty of scope to put these gentlemen. We've got to be wary of that mortars. The mortars will butcher these in seconds if we're not careful. Our strike force here on the right flank. We've got a good defensive line. Let's begin. There it is. We now know where they're coming from. There's a lot of cavalry going to be moving in here. Oh, we left them out there, sir. What an absolute imbecile. What an absolute imbecile. Oh, my goodness me. Absolutely butchered there, sir. Oh, gentlemen, don't stroll. This is not a Sunday parade, sir. Oh, they are well fortified here. We've got to disrupt these lines. We have to do it, sir. If they want to fight, then we'll oblige. We are not afraid, but this is not going to be an easy fight. Discipline is going to be absolutely key here. Let's pin them down. Now they're pouring all their forces here. Here they come. They fall upon these squares here. And they are as well. What an absolute wonder. Oh, what a shot. They're shaken, they're broken. Now they're going to start moving all their forces now. Looks like they're going to start moving their flanks. We've broken this flank here, possibly. Looks like they're stuck there. Broken one right on the flanks here. Well done, sir. We'll get some more reinforcements in here. Now they're going to start panicking, because now we've got three regiments rolling up on their left flank here. Our right. Bombarding them as well at the same time. That is the shatter they've got. Nope, wait, gentlemen. Back here. Let the squares deal with them. The squares will take care of them. Oh, we've got more. Jake Jaeger coming down here. Hold that line, hold that square. bleeding slightly? I don't think so, sir. Get in square, get in square! Absolutely dismantle this right flank here. Before they can reshape that, rather. Shattered, sir. We've got to swamp them. Oh my goodness me, that's a lot of cavalry. We're going to get swamped here on this flank if we're not careful. That's a lot of cavalry coming in, my goodness me, we've got to be quick here. The square way too quickly there. Now they've broken, look at that. Here they come, here they come. Gotta prepare ourselves now. We've got light cavalry. Two regiments here, two regiments there. Let's prepare for this charge. The light cavs and the hussars coming in. Absolutely crunch them there, sir. Come on, keep firing, lads. Get them, keep pouring the fire on. I'm gonna... Oh, what a fine, fine show here, gentlemen. I'll put an end to these. Put an end to them. We've got to get in there before these gentlemen come down here. We can move on this here and then dismantle this. Oh, what
brute. Right in the flanks. Come on, lads. Get him in the flanks now. Got to roll this flank up here. Oh, we've absolutely mauled this front, this line here, this left line flank here is absolutely mauled. Oh, they've run, they've had enough, but they fought with exemplary bravery here, sir. We do have one regiment here still left. I think we'll push this flank here. Thank you, gentlemen. If you would obey the orders, thank you very much. Broken one through that mortar there has been an absolute monster. We really have mauled these here. Now we're going to pull away. We've got these moving up on our flanks here. Gendarmerie coming in now as we retreat. I can absolutely assure you, this is not... Are we going to reinforce this flank? I think, what the blazes have we got two generals coming into the fight for? That... back down that way, sir. If you would please get out of this firing line, for goodness sake, sir. Crush these reserves. Oh, that was a close call. That was a real close call. Look at this. I've been absolutely bamboozled here. Let's pull back. Both broken. Torn this flank apart here. Oh, look at the losses. They're absolutely extraordinary. This is an absolute joy. Oh, what an app. Look at this. American cavalry at this fine, sir. Absolutely ripped this flank apart. I mean, look at their lines have been absolutely decimated. They've reconfigured their lines now. So we are going to move in here and deal the damage here. Nothing left of them. We're going to get straight into them. Absolutely get stuck into these. We can't give our cavalry any rest at all. On your way, cowards. Don't dodge them. Little do they know what's coming for them. Horse stakes here, anti-cab stakes here. Grenadiers, we've got to be wary of the grenadiers. Scripts. Get in there, lads. Don't get caught on that. Don't get caught on that. Now, lads, careful. They're moving against us now. Now they're moving against us. We've absolutely given them a damn good fashion here. Conscripts are moving in. And expatriates, I think that's might be all they have. Stuck in there, we've got a punch move. We engage. Shrapnel shot. Stand fast, lad, stand fast. They've gone, they've had enough. Oh my goodness, we've been. Let's get out of here, let's get out of here, let's get out of here, lads. Shattered medium. What a fight this has been. This flank has been rolled up all day long. Got to thread the needle here because we've got these anti-horse stakes here. As we thought, they've moved against us now. Now is the time to shut the door on them. Will they get caught on their own? Oh, they've gone. Oh, good grief. They've just blitzed their own infantry. That's a wonder. Might be the shatter. They've had enough. But what a fight they've put up. I mean, they have absolutely been a joy. They've butchered this right, this flank here. What a wonder. Come on, lads. What the blazes? Why have we got these forces coming in here? These gentlemen have been hard here, sir. Oh, what a shot. They've still got additional troops moving in. What a brutish fight this has been, sir. I'll pull this line back. Hussars. Oh, what a shot. That is the proof of the pudding of the howitzers. The howitzers are absolute monsters, sir. Fight to them. Oh, they've gone. They've had enough. My goodness me, how much infantry do they have here? Thank you. time to deal with each other. It's a never-ending stream of German forces here. Wow, we got absolutely butchered there. Oh, they are tough, those musketeers. Come on, put an end to them, sir. They want to fight them, by Jove, we'll give it to them. It's been a tough fight this has. Have absolutely no... Been to no illusions, my friends. This has been a brutal fight here to try and unhinge the German flank here. Time to roll these gentlemen up. I think we're going to go and deal with those mortars. Double time, please, only double time. Into the flank of these. Let's deal with them. Let's deal with these mortars here. They've been an absolute menace. Those there have just simply stuck there for some reason. I'm not sure why. Thankfully, we're on the clock here, so we can fast move forward very quickly if needs be. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness me, that was a brutal attack, but by the time we get through that, we should be ready to steamroll the rest of this line. Right, let's move in here. Let's close the door on these gentlemen. Let's put the death knell here for these, and let's get rid of this mortars once and for all. Then don't dawdle. Put an end to this. What a fight. They buckled. Yes. Gone. At last. shattered. All of them shattered. Absolutely ripped them to shreds here. But it's taken a lot of fight. A lot of fighting to get to this point. It really has. Wow, what a brutal fight that was. And whom else remains? Yes. Close victory indeed, sir. Wow. We lost 1,778. They lost 4,000, nearly 5,000 men there. We've got 10,000 men remaining. We've absolutely given them... Look at that, the Crassus Line Guards. I don't know, wonder. Crassus Line Guards, 20, look at that, 24 pounder. As soon as they came onto the field, they'd absolutely butchered them. What a fight that was. Yeah, away with you, sir. They've all...
Forward!
Yeah.
For crown and country!
Would you look at that? They've now moved to this sort of cauldron here in Munich. Excellent. Plus one to command. Plus one to command cavalry units. Excellent here. Art of war. Plus one to morale in battles. Absolutely fantastic. I think we can also probably move against Munich here. We can just move these forces here. As you can see, we're starting now to sort of really ramp up what we've got in going on here. I think my friends will have one turn here. And we shall end this episode. But I think we'll actually end this episode here. I'd like to get the council's advice. Do we now push down towards Munich with all guns blazing? Because we've effectively opened up a path here, right into here. We can go to Nuremberg here and punch a hole directly through to Munich. We can then move these forces. We can deal with this army here. This sort of remnants of this force we fought up here could be dealt with. Then we can move to surround Munich once and for all. Can we actually move in here? There's Stuttgart here. This army's being replenished and repaired, which is excellent to see. But do we now move in against Munich directly here and ignore everything else? Just effectively move these forces down here and move these army group in here. We can deal with this force, doesn't give us any problems, and head directly for Munich here. We can also pull forces from here and indeed from around Dresden. Excuse any noise in background, my friends. You can probably guess whom that might be. But if we can move forces from Dresden as well, from Saxony all the way down here, and just absolutely go for Munich. The council's advice is always and always needed, my friends, and always will be needed here. And we've got the Marines moving down here towards Hungary as well, which will be a fight for another time. But let me know what you think, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. We've now cleared a path, a clear path to Munich. Stuttgart is in our control. And we are, my friends, going to be punching now all we can now to get Munich, the last bastion, the last great capital of the German Empire in the West. Once we've taken this, we've then cleared the entire west and north here of Europe is under full American control. We can take Olmutz here, that wouldn't be a problem at all. We can then clear the forces here along the Carpathian Mountains here, and then we can finally put ourselves into the fight here. There's even many of the council calling for us to use these forces here to attack into the Balkans and effectively cut the base away here of the German forces, which we'll probably do. We'll get these gentlemen reinforced and replenished. We won't do it exactly now. And then we'll move in and take these cities here, effectively undermining sort of the last remnants here of the German forces, the German Empire here in the Balkans. It won't be easy. They've still got many, many troops available here. And indeed, they've got all these troops available still in the Don here. So he's still not over, but the light at the end of the tunnel. If the Spanish enter the war, then we definitely need to take Munich quickly. But I'm going to wait for the council's advice here, and I'm really, really counting on the council to come to our aid here. And I know most of the council, yes, man, take Dresden for goodness sake, just take it, go all guns blazing for it. And I know that's pretty much what it is. But there might be some other options available as well that I maybe haven't thought of. Council always comes up with some wonderful ideas, it really do. And leave that in your capable hands, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, as always, please keep your comments coming down below. And as always, my friends, thank you for your wonderful support and your wonderful advice. It really does mean a lot to me. Whatever you do, my friends, please be safe. But until next time, bye for now.